What's going on, YouTube fam? It's your boy Tony2times, and we back with another video, man. And tonight, we're going to take it to D.C. We're going to take it to the past, and we're going to talk about that infamous headhitter from D.C., Wayne Silk Perry. Let's get right into it. Wayne Silk Perry is said to be the most infamous gangster to ever walk the streets of Washington, D.C., a.k.a. Drama City, and has even been called the Michael Jordan of the murder game. A professional headhitter and alleged killer, the streets of D.C. hold a certain level of respect for the goon they call Silk. And in Chocolate City, in the streets, it was by any means necessary. Wayne took that to a whole nother level. With nothing or nobody off limits, if you were on his hit list, you could be killed anywhere in front of anybody. It was said that Wayne would lay and wait for his victim all night until the right opportunity, then murder them. Murder, robbery, extortion was his game, and he mastered every aspect of that. In Wayne's era, it was a lot of serious players in the game, like Rafer Evans, and even Harlem Kingpin Alpo Martinez, who Wayne would later partner with and terrorize the streets of D.C. Wayne first started doing hits as a way to make money and just a way to get by. But with that, his rep and respect became infamous in the streets. It was said drug dealers wouldn't even drive their nice cars around Wayne because they were scared they would be robbed, kidnapped, or even worse, killed. All the big hustlers wanted Wayne on their team, but he wanted to make his own way. But dudes like Rafer Evans made sure they looked out for Wayne so he wouldn't get down on them. With old school gangster ways, Wayne took any hit if the price was right. Nobody was safe. Wayne told his homies, "I don't shoot from across the street. I like to walk up on my target." Wayne treated the streets just like chess, playing mind games with weak-minded individuals and using fear to take over the city. And he ended up with business with Alpo after Alpo paid to bail him out of jail. Alpo was smart. With trouble in D.C., after being shot, he saw opportunity when dudes didn't want to bail Wayne out because they were scared of him. Alpo knew if he did this, the type dude Wayne was, he would be loyal to him for life. So after Alpo bailed Wayne out, they got to it. The streets got cold. The streets got vicious. It was a lot of drugs floating through D.C. at the time, but it also was a lot of people falling, a lot of people getting killed. The streets was basically off the hook. This in the 80s. So with Alpo doing what he was doing in D.C., flooding the streets, and now he had Wayne behind him, you know, they was pressing up on everybody. They wanted a piece of everything. And he was sending Wayne on hits. You know, anybody who disrespected them, you feel me? It was said that on a basketball court, they was playing basketball. Alpo sent the dude that he was in tour with. He passed the book bag to Wayne. Broad daylight, Wayne smoked the dude. They said everybody kept playing basketball like nothing even happened. It's allegedly been said, too, that one of Wayne homeboys said they was riding around with a dude. You feel me? This dude supposed to have been a killer throughout the city. You know, Wayne was in the car with them. You know, he pulled up on them. He was like, "Who this dude is? Y'all know him?" Dude was like, "Yeah, he real. He a real one." Wayne like, "Man, he soft. I see right through him." So the dude took offense to this. He said it to his face. So the dude pride got in the way. They said Wayne slapped all hell out of him, pulled out the gun, made him strip, shot him in his ass, and made him walk home. And this dude was supposed to be a killer. They said he seen through people like that. You know, he had that eye of the tiger. When you in the streets like that, and you a street dude, and you came up in that era, you feel me? It's like your mind, you think different. He was a shark, you feel me? Some people be guppies, some people be sharks. And he had that shark guy, you know? But the worst thing he could have probably ever did was partner with Alpo. Because later in the game, after Alpo got hot, after the feds got on Alpo, you know, one of the first people he gave up was Wayne. You know, Wayne was hurt about that because he thought Poe really loved him. He did a lot for that dude. He had a lot of street cred before Alpo even came in the city. So just off Wayne's name, Alpo was safe. Then you had dudes like Rafer Evans that was getting a lot of money in the city too. But you know, Wayne wasn't as close to them. So you know, they had to do their own thing. But man, when the feds got on Poe got jammed up. That's when they grabbed Silk up. When they grabbed Wayne up, they was trying to give him the death penalty. But you know, he ended up giving that back and was able to serve life. You know, he's still in prison to this day. You know, everybody want to get an interview with Wayne Perry. It ain't too many of them floating around. But it was said that this dude was so dangerous that he felt like if you was weak, even if you had money, if you was weak, he was going to take it from you. And if you had a problem with it, you had to do something about it. Now, growing up in Baltimore, I've been around dudes like this. You know, dudes like this, they treacherous, you feel me? It ain't no love with them. They don't care who you is. They don't care who you know. You know, some people got picks. If your family's strong, they won't try you. Or if you come from a certain background, they won't try you. You got tattoos on your face, they think you tough, they won't try you. He wasn't that type dude. And with him doing what he did in the streets of D.C., his name is still legendary because he never told. He never ratted. He held his weight. You know, he didn't even hold a grudge. You feel me? At first, he had a grudge towards Alpo. But after a minute, it was said that Wayne was like, man, whatever. You know, he took it just like a soldier because he knew what came with the street life. And I feel like that's the problem nowadays. People don't know what come with the street life. So, man, I'm bringing y'all this story like I always tell y'all to update y'all on the past, but to also steer the youth away from going to the streets. Y'all think y'all ready to deal with dudes like this, man? You know, like Wayne Perry. Think about it. Y'all young dudes really think y'all want to run into somebody like this? So, man, like I said, it ain't telling. It ain't snitching. It's public information. We don't do none of that on the channel. But I want y'all to leave y'all comments below. I'm going to do an updated video on Rafer Evans probably a little later this week. If you're new to the fam, be sure to subscribe. Hit the notification bell for uploads. Family, y'all already know what it is. If you want to support the growth of the channel, check out the links in the description. Everything is appreciated. Check out the merchandise. Check out the Patreon. Love, fam.